Good afternoon, students. Who is the first group? Matri.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. Manashree, na? Start your presentation. Who is presenting? Present fast. Group is ready. Manashree.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Who is presenting?
Prachi.
Prachi Patil, present your screen. Share your screen first. Start your presentation.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good.
Good afternoon, respected ma'am, and each and everyone present in the meeting. I am Manashree Mathe, roll number 24, and our topic for the presentation is Laplace transform of periodic function. Next slide.
Your group members' roll number I need. Yes, this slide. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. These are my group members: Sakshi Khedekar, roll number 17; Prachi Patil, roll number 34; Bhagyashree Yadav, roll number 45. And me, Manashree Mathe, roll number 24. First of all, we will see introductory part of the process. Before introducing a Laplace transform information, I would like to introduce the person who invented this topic, Pierre and Laplace, the French mathematician who studied this transform in 1782. So to understand Laplace transform of a periodic function, first let's understand what is Laplace transformation. In mathematics, transforms are applied to transform a variable from one form to another to make the equation easy to handle. Laplace transform also does the same thing, that is, it transforms higher order differential equation into a polynomial form, which is far easier than solving differential equations directly. It is a shortcut for solving differential equations. It is very powerful tool that enables us to readily deal with linear differential equation with discontinuous forcing function. But there are various transforms like Fourier transform. But what makes Laplace transform differ from them is that they are defined for both stable and unstable systems, whereas Fourier transform are defined only for stable system. Then we'll see the definition of Laplace transform of periodic function. A function f of t is said to be a periodic if this exists a constant t, where t is greater than zero, such that f of small t is equals to f of small t plus 3 capital T. In general, f of t plus n t is equals to f of t for all t, where n is an integer and t is period of function, if f of t is periodic function with period t. Then the Laplace of f of t is equals to 1 upon 1 minus e raised to the power minus st, integral of 0 to t e raised to the power minus st f of t. Now I would like to pass Prachi Sakshi Khedekar to explain further presentation.
Property statement. Let f of t be a periodic function with a period t, then prove that Laplace of f of t equals to 1 divided by 1 minus e raised to minus st integral 0 to t e raised to minus st f of t dt. In proof, the standard definition of a Laplace is Laplace of f of t is equal to integral 0 to e raised to minus st f of t dt. Here the limit is from 0 to infinity. We will split the limit in the form of a according to the time period, then integration becomes integral 0 to t e raised to minus st f of t dt plus integral t to 2t e raised to minus st f of t dt plus integral 2t to 3t e raised to minus st f of t dt plus so on. Here the first integral matches with our proof, so we are not going to make any changes in the first. We will change in the second and third. So we put small t is equal to u plus capital T in integral 2 and t is equal to u plus 2t in integral 3. When we put t is equal to u plus t in integral 2, du is equal to dt. And when we put t is equal to u plus 2t in integral 3, the new limits are u is equal to 0 to u is equal to t. When we put these values in the integral, it becomes integral 0 to t e raised to minus st f of t dt plus integral 0 to t e raised to minus s u plus t f of u plus t du plus integral 0 to t e raised to minus s in the bracket u plus 2t f of u plus 2t du. Now we will multiply minus s to the inner bracket u plus t, so it becomes integral 0 to t e raised to minus su into e raised to minus st in the second integral. And also when we multiply minus s to in the third integral, it becomes 0 to t e raised to minus su into e raised to minus 2st f of u plus t du. Now the we have to replace t by u. Now when we replace t by u, it becomes integral 0 to t e raised to minus st f of t dt plus e raised to minus st integral 0 to t e raised to minus f of u plus t du plus e raised to minus 2st integral 0 to t e raised to minus su f of u plus 2t. Next, replacing u by t in integral 2 and 3, we take the common part 1 plus e raised to minus st plus e raised to minus 2st and plus so on, and out of the bracket integral 0 to t e raised to minus st f of t dt. By using 1 plus a square plus a cube plus so on is equal to 1 minus 1 divided by 1 minus a, it becomes 1 by 1 minus e raised to minus st integral 0 to t e raised to minus st f of t dt is equal to our RHS. Hence proof. Now I will like to pass Bhagyashree.
Next slide, example based on Laplace transformation. So first question is find the Laplace transformation of f of t equals to sine omega t, where t is greater than 0 and less than pi by omega equals to 0, where t is greater than pi by omega and less than 2 pi upon omega. Solution. We know that f of t is a periodic function with period 2 pi upon omega. T is equals to 2 pi upon omega. Laplace f of t is equals to 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus 2 pi s upon omega. Integral 0 to 2 pi upon omega f of t dt. So there is we put t in the place of 2 pi upon omega is equals to 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus 2 pi s upon omega, bracket integral of 0 to pi by omega e raised to minus st sine omega t dt plus integral pi by omega to 2 pi upon omega e raised to minus st 0 dt. Now there is a formula to solving this integral of e raised to at sine bt dt is equals to e raised to at upon a square plus b square into a sine bt minus b cos bt. Next slide, please. So after comparing this formula with equation, consider a is equals to minus s and b is equals to omega. So Laplace f of t is equals to 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus 2 pi s upon omega, bracket e raised to minus st upon s square plus omega square into minus s sine omega t minus omega cos omega t, bracket close, is equals to 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus 2 pi s upon omega, bracket e raised to minus s pi omega upon s square plus omega square sine omega pi minus sine pi minus omega cos pi plus e raised to 0 upon sine square plus omega square into s sine 0 plus omega cos 0. We know that sine 0, sine pi and sine 0 is 0. So further 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus 2 pi s upon omega, bracket minus e raised to minus s pi upon s square plus omega square into omega plus 1 upon s square plus omega square into omega, bracket close, equals to in this take a common so that Laplace f of t is equals to omega into e raised to minus s pi omega plus 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus 2 pi s upon omega into s square plus omega square. Next slide. For solving Laplace law, there was some important formulas. First, Laplace e raised to at is equals to 1 upon s minus a, where s minus a, s is greater than a. Second, e raised to Laplace e raised to minus at is equals to 1 upon s plus a, s is greater than a. Third, Laplace sine at is equals to a raised to s square plus a square, s greater than 0. 4. Laplace cos at is equals to s upon s square plus a2, where s is greater than 0. 5th, Laplace sine h at is equals to a raised to s square minus a square, s is greater than mod of a. Next, Laplace cos h a t is equals to s upon s square minus a square, s is greater than mod of a. Laplace t raised to n is equals to r into n plus 1 upon s raised to n plus 1 if n is fraction. Laplace t raised to n is equals to n factorial upon n factorial upon s raised to n plus 1 if n is a positive integral. Laplace c raised to a t is equals to 1 upon s minus a log c, where c is greater than 0. I would like to Next slide will be presented by Prachi Patel.
Thank you. Applications of Laplace transform. Engineering application. In electrical circuit, a Laplace transform used to analysis of linear time invariant system. Laplace transform is widely used by electronic engineers to quickly solve the differential equations occurring in the analysis of electrical circuit. Second, machine learning. Machine learning focuses on prediction based on known properties learned from training data, where Laplace equation is used to determine the prediction and to analyze the step of knowledge and databases. Third, digital signal processing. Laplace is heavily used in signal processing. Using Laplace or Fourier transform, we can produce signal in frequency domain. Laplace transformation is used in processing data signal during their transmission. For instance, if signal smooth over time, it means frequency domain is like to be small frequency. Process control. Laplace transformation is plays the key role in important in process control. Control concept and techniques. It helps the analysis the variables which can be altered and helps to produce desired manipulating in the result. System modeling. Laplace transform is used to simplify calculation in system modeling and where large number of differential equation. Nuclear physics. It is very important in order to get true form of radioactive decay. A Laplace transform is used. It makes studying analytic part of nuclear physics possible. Real life application of Laplace transform. Call completion in wireless networks. Semiconductor mobility. Vehicle vibration on compressed rail. Behavior of magnetic and electric fields above the atmosphere. Other applications of Laplace transform. To find moment generating function in statistics. To solve the problem related to communication and network analysis. To determine the structure of astronomical object from spectrum. Conclusion. Laplace transformation is powerful tool using in different areas of mathematics, physics and engineering. With the ease of application of Laplace transform in many applications, many research software have made it possible to stimulate the Laplace transformable. In conclusion, we can say that the Laplace transform of periodic function is not only a feasible choice but also a technologically smart choice. The above listed pros just prove that there is tremendous opportunity for the growth of this concept throughout the world. References. These are the references we have to refer.
Okay, fine. See, very good presentation. And I have one question. Basically, why the name periodic function has come for this? What do you mean by periodic function? The next group can start. No answers? You don't know the answers? Tell me. If you are not knowing, tell me first.
Ma'am, a periodic function is a function that repeats its value at a regular interval.
Yes, yes. Very good. Very good, Sakshi. It repeats after a certain interval. That means if the period pi means after the interval of pi, the value repeats. So the curve also will come like that. Okay, periodic function at period A means after a period of A, it is again repeating. So we will get a curve accordingly. Okay, very good presentation. Good collection also. Lot many applications you have gathered. Lot of efforts has been put up. Very good. The next group
Thank
can
you,
start
ma'am.
A presentation. Yeah. Gajagosh group, no? Next one.
Yes, ma'am.
Start your presentation.
Yes, ma'am.
Presentation.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Good morning, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone. Today.
Go to the second slide. I want to note your roll numbers.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Pawar Harshal, roll number 36. Yash Rathod, 39 roll number. Myself, Gajagosh Devdutta, 9 roll number. And Mauryal Ayush, 28.
Okay.
Ma'am. One problem is there.
Yes, tell me.
Ma'am, one of our group member is not present today. Maurya Ayush.
Maurya Ayush. What is the problem?
Ma'am, we have contacted him, but he's not replying.
28, no?
Yes,
so
ma'am.
So inform him he has to give me separately his presentation. Okay. So I
okay,
will
ma'am.
Not give marks for him. For you three people, I will give the mark today. Okay. Okay, continue.
Next slide. Our topic for today's project is Fourier transform and their application. Next slide. As per the first slide introduction, Joseph Fourier, Baron Fourier, is a French mathematician known as Egyptology and administrator. He showed how the conduction of heat in solid bodies may be analyzed in terms of infinite mathematical series, now called by his name the Fourier series. Next slide. The Fourier series gives us a method decomposing periodic function in their sinusoidal components. The Fourier series can also be viewed as special introductory case of Fourier transform. So no Fourier transform tutorial is complete without a study of Fourier series. Our topic Fourier transform, it is an extension of the Fourier series that results when the period of the represented function is lengthened and allowed to approach infinity. It is a mathematical transform that decomposes functions depending on space or time into functions, depending on spatial or temporary frequency. It is also used to decompose an image into sine and cosine components. The definition of the transform or Fourier transform is given as a function derived from a given function and representing it by a series of sinusoidal functions. It is also a function where f of x is defined on minus infinity to plus infinity, is a piecewise continuous in each in the finite interval, and is absolutely integrable in minus infinity to plus infinity. Then the Fourier transform of f of x can be expressed as f of x is equal to 1 upon root of 2 pi integral from minus infinity to plus infinity f of x e raised to isx dx. Next slide's properties are going to be explained by Herschel. One second. Ma'am, these examples were going to be explained by Ayush and formula. Hello, ma'am. Ma'am. Yeah. Ah, yes, sir. Go to the applications.
Good afternoon, everyone. Here are real-life applications of Fourier transform. Point number one, signal processing. LTI systems and filtering. Fourier transform is used to realize the filtering, modulation, and sampling of the signal, which is the most important application of Fourier transform in signal processing. Point number two, light, diffraction, interference, and Young's experiment. Light is both particle and wave. According to the Young's slit experiment suggests that light is a wave and waves are functions, and functions have Fourier transform. We'll see a great application of Fourier transform in the physical world. Point number three, Fourier transform can also be applied to the solution of differential equations. Point number four, radiation from surface, currents, horn antennas, and RCS. It is used in determining radiation patterns of horns and antennas. Determining the field radiated from electric currents is useful in scattering applications, with the most prevalent example being RCS, radar cross section. Next slide, please. Other applications of Laplace transform. It is used in designing electrical circuits. It is also used in solving differential equations. It is also used in sonar, cryptography, and oceanography. Next slide. Conclusion. Fourier transform provides information regarding frequency and short time transfer, gives only constant resolution. Wavelet transform is preferred over Fourier transform and short time Fourier transform since it provides multi-resolution. Fourier transform has a multitude of applications in all the fields of engineering, but has a tremendous contribution in image process fields like image. Reference books like Engineering Mathematics 3 by G.V. Kumbhojkar, The Fourier Transform and Its Application by Professor Brad Osgood.
Okay, fine.
That's
okay, good presentation. And I think I found one of the... Go to your fourth slide. Go back. After that, just scroll it. I'll just... see, all your slides should be justified. See this slide, the previous one. All unevenly it is there, na? So always whenever you are presenting, it has to be evenly, the left-hand side, right-hand side, the entry. So you have to justify the content, okay? That will look a good PPT. Understood?
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, then go back. Next slide. Next. Next. Okay, just a minute. Before that, just previous one. signal pro real life applications, signal processing, light. See, you have given that just a broad spectrum. See, light, diffraction, interference, and Young's experiment. These are all a wide, broad spectrum. So exactly what it is, how it is related, that you have to correlate. Understood? Yes?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Otherwise, very good presentation. So you just inform that roll number 28 to give it later. Okay, to me.
Separately. Okay.
Maybe tomorrow, 12:45, I will give you the last at the end because already schedule is there. If anyone is not there, then otherwise Thursday. Okay. So whenever. First, let them write a message to me. What is the reason behind it? Why he could not join today? Then I will let him know. The next group, I think Jaiswal Tejas, start.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Good presentation, Gajagosh group. A lot of efforts have been put up. Very good.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Jaiswal Tejas. Yeah, present it. Who are all your members? Go to that slide first. Second slide, yeah.
Myself, Jaiswal Tejas, roll number 14. Pravesh Lohar, roll number 19. And Kunal Patole, roll number 35.
Okay. Okay, start your presentation.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Our project name is direct delta function, and here is a definition. Means in mathematics, direct delta function is generalized function or distribution introduced by physicist called Dirac. Definitions: the direct delta function, it can be loosely thought of as function on the real line, which is zero everywhere except at origin, where it is infinite. Delta x is equals to infinite when x is equals to 0, and delta x is equals to 0 when x is not equal to 0. This is the graphical representation of our project. This condition for the existence of direct delta function. First, as a distribution, the direct delta function is a linear function that maps every function to its value at 0. Second, in engineering and signal processing, the direct delta function is known as a unit impulse symbol, may be regarded through its Laplace transform as coming from boundary value of complex analytic function of complex variable. Properties will explain by Kunal Patole.
Properties, there are four main properties of direct delta function. They are, first, delta of t minus c is equal to 0 when t is not equal to c. Second, integration from c minus epsilon to c plus epsilon delta of t minus c dt is equal to f of c for epsilon is greater than 0. Third, integration from minus infinity to plus infinity delta of t minus c dt is equal to 1 for epsilon is greater than 0. Four, integration from c minus epsilon to c plus epsilon delta of t minus c dt is equal to 1 for epsilon is greater than 0. Laplace transform of direct delta function. By definition, L of f of t is equal to integration of 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt, that is equal to L of limit h tends to 0 f of t is equal to limit h tends to 0 L of f of t is equal to limit h tends to 0 integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt is equal to limit h tends to 0 integration from a minus h by 2 to a plus h by 2 e raised to minus st f of t dt is equal to limit h tends to 0 integration from a minus h by 2 to a plus h by 2 e raised to minus st 1 upon h dt. Next, is equal to limit h tends to 0 in bracket 1 upon h e raised to minus s into a plus h by 2 minus e raised to minus s into a minus h by 2 upon minus s is equal to e raised to minus as limit h tends to 0 e raised to h by 2 minus e raised to minus sh upon 2 upon sh is equal to e raised to minus as limit h tends to 0 2 sin h into sh upon 2 upon sh is equal to e raised to minus as limit h tends to 0 in bracket cos sh upon 2 is equal to e raised to minus as
Next part, Pravesh will explain.
Application of direct delta function in probability theory and statistics. The direct delta function is often used to represent discrete distributions, especially continuous distributions, using probability density function. Structural mechanics. Direct delta function is used to describe transient loads or point loads acting on structures, and they are described by derivative of direct delta function. Next slide. The direct delta function is expedient in quantum mechanics. The wave function of a particle given give the probability amplitude of finding a particle within a given region of space. Wave functions are assumed to be elements of the Hilbert space L2 functions, and the total probability of finding a particle within a given interval is the integral of the magnitude of the wave function squared over life applications. Simplifies calculations required for the studies of electron motion and propagation. Conclusion. Direct delta function is a powerful tool used in engineering. The direct delta function is used to get a precise notation for dealing with quantities involving certain type of infinity. Most specially, its origin is related to the fact that an eigenfunction belonging to an eigenvalue in the continuum is non-normalizable, that is, its normal is infinity.
Okay.
These are the reference books and websites.
Pravesh? See, your title is very small, na? Only direct delta function. It should have application or otherwise Laplace transform of direct delta function. That will be more appropriate, because only three words, title and all, many times the presentation will be rejected. So you have to change a little. It should be Laplace transform of direct delta function. Okay?
Okay, we will edit it.
Okay.
Thank you.
And as a computer or IT information technology, where exactly it is used in your branch? Do you have any idea? Yes or no?
No, ma'am.
Yes? Do you know the answer, Jaiswal?
No, ma'am.
So, okay, fine. Basically, in data science, it is used. Okay. Okay, you can go. Good present. Okay. The next group can start your presentation. Sakshi Mokan, your group.
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am. My name is Sakshi, and our mini project topic is Laplace transform of periodic function. And my group members are Tithi Nayak, Ayesha Pathan, Vaishnavi Wagh. So first, we need to understand what is a periodic function. The Laplace.
Go back to your slide. I want to note your numbers. 27.
30. 32 and 43.
Okay. Continue now.
The Laplace transform of the periodic function, with that is f of t, with time period capital T, equals the Laplace transform of one cycle of the function divided by 1 minus e raised to minus st. And this is the main formula which we will use to solve the periodic functions of Laplace transform. To prove this formula, first, we all know that the definition of Laplace transform is 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. And using this formula, we will derive the main formula. So in this definition, the limits are from 0 to infinity. So first we will write these limits in terms of time period. That is 0 to t, t to 2t, and 2t to 3t, and so on. Since it is till infinity, we can extend the terms according to us. Now we have extended up to the time period 3t. This is the condition which we will use to prove this formula. So the first term and the definition is almost the same. So we will not make any changes in the first term. The first term will remain same throughout the definition. Only the second and the third integral will change. So in the second integral, we will put t is equal to u plus t, and in third integral we will put t is equal to u plus 2t. Now we will differentiate this in terms of capital T. So we will get dt is equal to du, and here also dt is equal to du. Now since the integration will turn in form of u, so the limit should also be in the form of u. So here we will in place of small t, we will put capital T. So we will get u is equal to 0, and here we will get u is equal to t. Same here in the third integral, we will put t is, if we put t is equal to 2t, we will get u is equal to 0. And if we put 3t, then we will get u is equal to t. So now after the substitution and after changing the limits, we will in place of t, here we will put u plus capital T, and here u plus 2t. In the next step, we will multiply this s inside the bracket, and after that we will get e raised to minus su into e raised to minus st f of u plus t du, and in the third integral, e raised to minus su into e raised to minus 2st f of u plus 2t du. Now the integration is in the form of u, so e raised to minus st is constant in both the terms, so we will take it outside the bracket. After that, our terms will become zero integration from 0 to t e raised to minus su f of u plus t du plus e raised to minus 2st integration of 0 to t e raised to minus su f of u plus t du. Now using this condition, here f of t is equal to f of t plus capital T is equal to f of t plus 2t. So here we can write f of u plus t as f of u, and here also f of u plus 2t as f of u. So the next step will be e raised to minus st integration of 0 to t e raised to minus su f of u du plus e raised to minus 2st integration from 0 to t e raised to minus su f of u du. Now we will replace u by t in the second and third integral. After replacing it, we will get all the three terms common. Just here we have e raised to minus st, and here we have e raised to minus 2st. So now we will take the common common outside the bracket. So here 1 plus e raised to minus st plus e raised to minus 2st, and so on. And the common term will be e raised to integration 0 to t e raised to minus st f of t dt. Now this e raised to minus 2st can also be written in this form, which is same, that is e raised to minus st the whole square. And this is the formula: 1 plus a square plus a cube plus so on is equal to 1 upon 1 minus a. So here our a is e raised to minus st. So using this formula, the last term will be 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus st, and the common term, that is integration from 0 to t e raised to minus st f of t dt. And this is the RHS, that is our main formula here. Now I request my friend Tithi to explain some sums based on this formula.
So in the first sum, it is said that find the Laplace transform of f of t, where the limit of t is given from 0 to pi by 3. And when the limit is between pi by 3 to 0, the value is 0. Since we know that f of t is a periodic periodic function with period 2 pi by omega, so the value of t will be is equal to 2 pi upon omega. So now from here, using the basic general formula, that is Laplace transform of f of t is equal to 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus st integration of 0 to 2 t e raised to minus
st f of t dt. So now in the question, it is limits are already given that when the limit is from 0 to also the value of t is given, which is 2 pi upon omega. So writing the same as it is, 1 upon 1 minus e raised to 2 pi s upon omega, substituting the value of t in this equation, integration of 0 to 2 pi upon omega e raised to minus st f of t dt. In the next step, we will write 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus 2 pi upon s upon omega as it is. And next, we will substitute the values given in the main question. It is given in discontinuous form and
okay, continuing. Skip the problem. Problem is fine. Go to the application. Who is going to give?
Applications will be explained by Aisha.
Okay.
So here I'm going to start with the real life applications. The very first is Laplace transform is widely used by electronic engineers to solve quickly differential equations occurring in the analysis of electronic circuits. The second is system modeling. So in system modeling, Laplace transform is used to simplify calculations in system modeling where large number of differential equations are used. Now the third is digital signal processing. One cannot imagine solving digital signal processing problems without employing Laplace transform. Nuclear physics. In order to get the true form of radioactive decay, a Laplace transform is used. It makes easy to study analytic part of nuclear physics possible. And the fifth is process control. So Laplace transform, it is used for process controls. It helps to analyze the variables which when altered produce desired manipulations in the result. Some of the examples in science and engineering fields in which Laplace transforms are used is to solve the differential equations which occurs in the fields. Further would be continued by my friend Vaishnavi.
Okay.
Conclusion. The knowledge of Laplace transform has in recent years become an essential part of mathematical background required of engineers and scientists. This is because the transform method is an easy and effective means for the solution of many problems arising in engineering. The method of Laplace transformation is proving to be the most effective and easy way of solving differential equations, and hence it is replacing other methods of solution of the differential equation. References.
Okay, fine. So your title is what? Periodic functions, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Laplace transform of periodic function has lot of, so why the name we are calling it as periodic function?
Ma'am, as it repeats itself after a particular interval.
Yes. After a particular period, it is repeated. So accordingly, you will get the curve. Accordingly, you will have the explanation, the conclusion, everything. And it has wide range of applications in all the almost electronics and many engineering as well as computer engineering, information technology also. Good presentation. Okay, you all can leave. Very good.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.